So now let's go to another concept, the concept of life. Okay, let us, before we get to that, there's one slide that we missed. Let's talk about what is the difference between Swar Saptak and Swar Samvad. This is a really important concept. We should have presented this before we talked about rag. Let's look at a scale, a Shuddha scale with Shuddha Madhyamam. So all the notes are Shuddha, including Madhyamam. And let's take a rag, God Malhar, and sing the same scale and see what the difference is between a Saptak, a scale, and a rag. So let's do the Saptak first. So that's a saptak. It's a simple saptak. Every note is given equal importance. You sang the entire scale. Now let's sing the same thing as a rag.
पहले सप्तक फिर एक बार गाता हूँ, फिर राग गाता हूँ।
सारे गम पद निसा सारे ध प माग रेसा
राग
सारे गम
Madhyam jaan khati hai, because it takes all that energy into that Madhyam. So God Malhar is centered around that Madhyam. So all the phrases, he kept coming back to that Madhyam and establishing it. So it is the same thing, same scale that he, so when you wait on certain notes, it takes certain phrases faster than the others, then it becomes a rag. So what is important that you notice is that in this case, the rag actually has its own intrinsic lay. Some notes are held longer, like in the Vadi Swar or the Samvadi Swar, is held longer. Whereas the other Sare, Sa, Regama, Re and Ga have very little importance. They take just a little fraction of a beat. Whereas Madhyam is held longer. So rag itself has an intrinsic lay, whereas in a saptak there is no intrinsic lay. Each note has equal importance, they have same time interval. So that's important to note in a rag, that, you know, before we talk about lay and taal, we have to understand that rag itself has its own intrinsic laya. So when we make compositions too, we should pay attention to the intrinsic lay that exists in the rag. So when he did Ritu Baraka, that Madhyam, he held that for a long time. Phir se Guruji, Ritu Baraka.
Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa ra pa ma ga re sa Ritu Baraka aayi koyale ya bole na lage amo vake drare ritu barkha aai
So there you have the intrinsic lay that exists within the rag. And so when you compose also, that composition should take into account the intrinsic lay that exists in the rag. Only then the beauty of the rag comes into the bandish. So now let's talk about what is tal, what is lay, and what is tal. So let's do a simple exercise. In a lay, when you say something has lay, that means the time intervals between the beats is equal. So when you say, let's clap, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so that has lay, so that has equal intervals. There's no lay there. They don't have equal intervals when the beat. So lay means there's equal intervals. The other important thing about lay is a horizontal movement. So it's an eternity. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 1, 1, 1. It goes on and on. So it's a horizontal line. So it's like the x-axis. Whereas now when you talk about tal has a very, it is lay, but it has one more important thing. It's a concept. It has 1, 2, 1, 2, or you can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. So it is like it's cyclical. It's like a circle. So you do 1, 2, 3, 4. So 1 is the sum, 2, Kali, 4. 1, 2, Kali, 4. So if you think of in Hindustani music, when you, any tal you take, whether it is, you know, a 10-beat cycle or 16-beat cycle, you can almost break it into two halves. The first half, which has the sum, the second half begins with the Kali. Kali is no beat. And so let's look at a 10-beat cycle. So there are 5 plus 5, so it's 2, 3, 2, 3. Because you can't break it into 4 equal quarters like you could do with a 16-beat cycle, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So you can break it into two halves. So first 8 and the ninth beat is Kali. First one is the sum. Whereas a 10-beat cycle, which is more complex, which is Japtal, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Kali, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Kali, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's how it goes. So, Dhina, Dhi, Dhina, Dhina, Dhi, Dhina, Dhina, Dhi, Dhina, Dhina, Dhi, Dhina. That's how it goes. Attention to every beat. dhina. Even the bandish goes that way. It pays importance to every beat. Dhina, dhi, dhina, dhina, dhi, dhina. You can hear that lay in the bandish itself. Now, what is one important thing is that, you know, japtal, when people sing, typically they sing with the tal. But when you start singing with slower tempo tals, like in Vilambit Hektal or something like that, in Shamrao Gharana, we not only pay attention to every beat in the cycle, but we actually pay attention to every fraction of a beat. So that means for every 1/4 of a beat, we are paying attention. So all compositions are perfect to tal, our laykari, even our bol alaps, laykari, bol tans, or bol upajas, all of them are done to perfect beat. So we pay attention not just to the matras in the tal cycle, but to the fraction of the matras that exist in the tal cycle. So let's look at some examples. So this concept of actually paying attention not just to the beats itself, but to the fraction of the beats is called Khanepuri way of singing. So that's how it's supposed to be sung. But today, if you listen to Hindustani music, people only pay attention to the sum. They come quickly to the 12th beat, pause a bit, and take the sum. That's not acceptable, because once the beat starts, the tal conditions the rag, so you have to go along with the tal. You cannot just forget about the tal and come back to the sum at a later time. So you have to pay attention to the beat as it's going along. That's called Khanepuri. So let's look at the different tempos in a tal cycle. So there are different tempos, different speeds at which you can sing. So the slowest tempo is called Vilambit tempo, Vilambit laya. Then the medium speed is called Madhya Laya, and the faster speed is called Drut Laya. So we'll take examples of each of these and sing Rag Chayanat. We'll sing in Vilambit Laya, then Madhya Laya, and then in Drut Laya. This is Vilambit Laya. It's a 12 beat cycle.
Yeah.
why does one sing in vilambit lay? It's a question to ask. We've said that rag is about sur, it's about melody. So melody can be expounded only in vilambit lay. So you give notes enough time. So if you want to establish the vadi, the samvadi, where we said rag has its own intrinsic lay, that intrinsic lay can be best exhibited in vilambit lay. That is why most of Shamrao Gharana happens in the vilambit lay. 80% of the music we do in vilambit lay. Because it gives you a chance to do complete justice to rag. And if classical music is about rag, then you've got to do justice to the rag. And so we sing in vilambit lay. Now let's look at Madhya Lay composition. We'll look at a 16-beat cycle, which is called... Sure. Not necessarily.
No. अभी मैंने दरबारी कन्नड़ा गाया, 11 मात्रा पर शुरू होता।
It doesn't matter. Some... Because you want to show the sum. Coming of the sum.
Sum पर आना है.
The first beat. The first beat is the most important beat in the Tal cycle. So you have to come like a climactic, you want to show the sum. See, this is the first, it is in the bandish that the Tal and Rag come together.
फर्स्ट से शुरू जरूर होगा मध्य लय में दिखाता हूँ उदाहरण एक अभी दिखाता हूँ
हाँ बट इन मध्य लय और इन द्रुत लय बट नॉट इन विलंबित सी रिमेंबर दैट